Murege kutisiya baba tichitambura murege kutisiya baba tichitambura murege kutisiya baba tichitambura
murege kutisiya baba tichitambura.
I will be there. I've got fathers and mothers who came simply because, you know, he wanted just a kombi. For 2 weeks, he will be gone. And the same mindset continues. Once I get this kombi down and I get this truck down and I get this house in Kwazana up and running and I get this one in Budiriro and I get this one. So it is investment after investment. And yet when I heard the man of God speak, and even the previous session we had, unless we humbly come back to God,
amen,
it is not going to be this generation,
amen,
to enjoy,
amen,
the sweetness of the sweat.
Yeah.
Now my prayer is, let it not also fail our children.
Amen.
And I hear him go down to Moses as a child. Now the next question is, it's a Zimbabwe no longer for you and me, but a Zimbabwe for our children. Remember when you go to heaven to say thank you to the Levite who gave birth to Moses. The teaching he gave as a family to Moses, to make him remember, because the issue of faith that has been talked about here, we are talking faith in two fronts. Here was somebody who is to be the heir to the throne of Egypt, and he has to give his back to all those players and go and join those who are toiling. Deuteronomy 18:18 says, I will raise you another prophet in whom I will plant my own words.
Yes.
And he will say what I will command. We have the man of God. As Paul says, it's no longer me who lives, but him who lives in me.
Amen.
So if it was God speaking, I think going before God, we really need to go knowing that we are not yet saints, we are sinners. We have created the situation in Zimbabwe. Our children, under the prayers of our own fathers, they managed to raise us up under the Zimbabwean cloud. We as fathers, we have failed to raise our own children under the Zimbabwean cloud. And we have to borrow an environment elsewhere. But it comes with its own tears. It's a package. God cannot raise a word for no reason. He cannot raise a prophet for no reason. If then in the days of Moses, he was raised because of the first Pharaoh, we are not going to DNA anybody. But circumstances under which we are, that's what is going to be our prayer point number one.
Amen.
The circumstances in which right now you and me are has made God to plant the word which Baba Makoto has given us.
Yes.
The circumstances. We are in a situation in a country where our own children, we are no longer the bona fide teachers of them. We have got circumstances where my child wants to go and sleep over, my wife wants to sleep over, father is sleeping over. How are we going to raise Moses? How are we going to raise a Moses? I loved chapter 2 of Exodus. It said, God-fearing women saved some boys in Egypt. God-fearing. The idea of fearing God, that's the one that is missing in me and in you as my brothers and sisters. Fathers no longer hold their position as fathers. Mothers no longer hold their position as mothers. Survival of the fittest. Circumstances would raise such a word. So he says, if you don't listen to that word, I will strike the nation with plans. So our investing is of no purpose. 127 Psalms says, these children are an inheritance from God.
Yes.
Moses' mother, after giving birth, discovered that Moses was beautiful. He was fine. Our own children are beautiful. Amen. They are good.
Amen.
And that beauty is not only in our eyes. Mm. Even the devil wants them. They are being taught. They are beautiful.
Yes.
So our prayer, Pastor Magodos and all pastors present, is for us to pray for our children. Mm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There's one verse I would kindly ask somebody to just read for me, Malachi chapter 4, verse 6.
Mureke kutisiya baba, tichitambura. Mureke kutisiya baba. Tichitambura, mureke kutisiya baba, tichitambura,
mureke kutisiya baba, tichitambura.